Well, Greece is at a stage that it has got a sound fiscal situation. We have been achieving the surpluses that have been agreed with our partners, and we have been actually overachieving the surpluses. The second thing is that we have growth in the economy, and the third very important element is that we have reached an agreement with our partners about the Greek debt, not only having our big part of the debt on a bilateral level or on the ESM, but also the creation of a buffer on the ESM as a security for a smooth exit to the markets when the program is concluded. So I think these are very, very important elements that are noted by the world markets. And this is why you see those very low prices with our bonds. I think there is a zero risk because this government has shown that can keep up to abide into the agreements, and within the agreements finding space to do extra things for the people that are in need, do more things for improving the investment atmosphere, and well, what we want to do after the program and before the program actually finishes is to have in place our own program of reforms that will take the country to the next page. The elements of our program are starting to be there, and I'm sure quite soon we'll put them together, present it to our European partners, and have this new page for Greece. I think that when the program finishes, this will dramatically improve the whole atmosphere in terms of investment, employment, job creation, and the steady growth path that has started for three consecutive quarters or four consecutive quarters now is going to keep going. I'm very optimistic that by the end of our first term, September 2019, we will have created something close to 500,000 jobs, and that would be a very good reason to present to the people to get re-elected. We have expressed interest from many parts of the world for investment in the telecom sector, for example. On top of that, we have decided to direct each and every euro available in investing in future-proof technologies. Increasing connectivity indexes, making people familiar with the applications that come together with this kind of technologies, I think is of great importance in order to develop this sector, which is, I believe, the sector of all sectors. It's a sector that can make each sector of the economy more productive and make our life easier, our job more creative and more productive, and our interaction with the public sector more effective. So in that sense, I think that it is well understood by us, and our job is to make it well understood by the people and international investors that things are changing on that sector radically. The impact is going to be great. We have prioritized the development of new generation access networks, and we are developing projects for rural and urban areas so that people can have cheap access to very high speed connectivity to the internet. This is going to change our lives radically. On top of that, we are working very, very rapidly on the digitalization of the public sector. You are in the Ministry of Digital Policy, Telecom and Media, and I'm happy to tell you that this ministry is fully digitalized and all papers are moved around, not by paper, but digitally. We can, I arrive in my office in the morning and I can have the workflow picture of what is going on, what is to be left to be done, and this is going to be expanded for the whole of the public sector within 2018. It is a huge project which we estimate that it's going to save us 400 million euros in costs per year. This is a shy estimation, I would say, because you cannot put a number on the working hours that you save when everything is there in front of you. Well, what we do is that we dedicate the available European funds in order to create exactly the team, I would say, of people that can educate people. So we're building educators. And as I said before, it is quite important not only to develop infrastructure, but to make people familiar with this, with the applications that come on top of this infrastructure. For example, we have been very, very successful in deploying the program for rural broadband. That is a program that costed us in the first phase 160 million euros to take high-speed internet to rural areas. That is the first step, but this has to be matched with an effort of familiarizing people with using the technologies and the new applications that come on top. So it is our priority. We're going to spend a lot of money on that, and I think that this is money that is going to pay back on the productivity of the economy. Joining forces is the key to taking the country to the next step, and I think the role of governments is to make sure that the interests of private enterprises are pursued in the broader interests of within the broader interests of the community, and in that sense this triangular cooperation is of paramount importance. First of all, I think Greece has proved in those recent years that can play a role of stabilizing the broader area. Everybody can see that we're in an area that has got a lot of places of instability, but Greece, with its international cooperation and its foreign policy, has shown that it can create triangles of stability with Israel, with Egypt and others. In that respect, it is the fact that we prioritize projects that connect countries in the long run. And projects in such infrastructure on energy and telecommunications are quite important. We are very, very happy that governments have engaged in this project, and we are very optimistic that it's going to be a project that is strategically important and of course profitable for the investors. Well, Greece can be a regional hub with a very, very crucial role for the world economy. Because if you look at the map, Greece is at the center of an area that above it, so to speak, it has got a mature market, which is the European Union. And this market is always in need for services of transport, telecom, energy. And below, as you look at the map, so to speak, is North Africa. And this is another area of 400 million people. We have every reason to work with like-minded countries in the region to stabilize this area. So we can utilize the potential of growth in this whole area. And in order to become a hub, we have to have credible networks. That's why we have put a lot of effort in completing the contemporary motorway network, which did take place almost a year ago, and now we have a very, very credible and operational motorway network. We're working on the new generation access networks, and we're working in upgrading our transport system, even with trains and ships and every aspect of transport facility. So in that respect, we can, we want, and we will achieve it. We will become a regional hub that is very crucial for the world economy. I think that the available funds from the European Union is the most crucial funding stream for completing these projects. For example, our motorway network has utilized European money mostly, and this is what is going to happen with our telecom networks. And I think this is, I mean, the targets that have been set for connectivity by the EU is, I would say, a good drive, a good incentive that we can constantly try to achieve. Well, it's been voted in, and we are at the stage that we're setting it up. And for the first time, we have a comprehensive policy in that respect. And it is exactly a field that we're bringing together entrepreneurs, research centers, and government. Already we have two very important agreements being signed. The first is with the European Space Agency to build a business innovation center in Greece, a business innovation center of the European Space Agency. And of course, we have the announcement of a very big investment of the company OHB for the construction of microsatellites and satellites in Greece. It should never be underestimated what can be achieved through enhancing this sector. Already, Greece has got an industry, a space industry, that brings 150 million of exports in the economy, and this has taken place without the actual help of the government and without having a coherent policy on that field. Now, I think we are starting with a very, very good indications and very, very encouraging signals from the market and, of course, the European community. Greek universities can build microsatellites from scratch. This capacity was not utilized for the interests of the country. In the past, they only participated once or twice in European programs. Now we have secured the funding so that we are building our constellation, our full constellation of microsatellites in 1 year and a half. And it is going to be built 100% in Greek universities. It seems to be long ago that Tsipras was almost the only one that was talking about the need of the countries of the South coming together and the need of applying policies with very important federal elements in the European level. This is a dialogue that has been now widely open, and I think we can be a protagonist in this dialogue. We have the capacity, and we have a very, I think, well-founded opinion on what can change and what should change in the Union so that we do not witness tragedies, economic tragedies, like the ones that we witnessed in Greece. We are very optimistic that this dialogue is going to be productive and that leaderships are ready to take the necessary steps and discuss even further measures that will make our Union stronger and revive the belief of our people to the common project.